So my name is Pete Lee, and like, don't feel bad. I thought I was gonna be Asian too. Everyone's always like, well, if your family's not Asian, then what are they? And I'm like, alcoholics. My family's from Wisconsin. They drink like Prohibition is gonna start up again tomorrow. My grandpa's like, drink it, chug it, slam it. I'm like, I can't, it's a daiquiri, it'll hurt. Like, I'm not a manly man, but oh, I know I look like a quarterback, but inside I am all cheerleader. Like, if I was strangling one of you right now, you'd be like, oh, your hands are so soft. Death tickles. In eighth grade, my mom sent me up for that Big Brothers Big Sisters of America program because I had no strong male role model in my life. And you know who that ticked off was my dad. Who's an interior decorator. Yeah, my dad gave me my Y chromosome, which is mine, was in cursive. I am married to my wife, and she's awesome. She was at our wedding, and she's great. The only thing that I don't like about being married is that my single friends are always bragging about all their casual hookups right in front of me. They're like, dude, last weekend, I hooked up with two chicks at once. And I'm like, oh man, my weekend was like monogamy. Yeah, we had our annual sex. Sorry, seasonal. My friends are like, dude, we're taking you to the strip club tonight. And I'm like, oh, I'm so there, but it's our cat's birthday. So like, either way, I'm gonna have a little tail on my lap. And like, I don't know if you guys can tell by looking at me, but I've never felt the rumble of like a motorcycle between my legs. Oh, but sometimes my cat sits on my lap and he purrs awful loud. I'm like, I don't even need a motorcycle. I need a lint roller, you know? And more guy friends. Sometimes I wish that I was like a manlier guy, but then I look at my grandpa and he's so manly that it's stupid. He's like, I never cry, I never cry, I never cry. I'm like, neither do flamingos and they're pink. My grandpa shows up to the bar with his motorcycle helmet underneath his arm. He's like, yeah, it's like I'm in a biker gang or something. I'm like, you look like you're on an elderly bobsledding team. My grandpa carries a gun with him everywhere. He's like, I just like to be the toughest guy wherever I go. And I was like, well, a gun doesn't make you tough. If you're truly the toughest guy wherever you go, you could just carry a flower, right? People would be like, what's your flower for, Sally? You'd be like, your grave. Like, I hope you don't have allergies. My grandpa came over to my apartment recently and he had a box and it was kind of wiggling and he's like, hey, sissy, because that's my nickname. He's like, hey, sissy, you know, a dog is a man's best friend, so I got you a cat. And he gave me a living, breathing cat. The cat's looking up at me like, I don't know either, dude. Just accept me, because otherwise he's my roommate. So I named my cat Grandpa. Because just like Grandpa, my cat has gray hair and big ears, you know, and he's really afraid of the bathtub. But he didn't get me like a little tiny meow meow kitty cat. He got me a gigantic obese cat from the pound. My cat weighs 23 pounds, all right? Most cats weigh 8. People walk into my apartment, they're like, oh, this is a raccoon. And he's so fat he can't even meow, right? You know, like most cats are like, meow. My cat's like, raw, 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 raw. All right, I'm Pete Lee. Thanks for being a great crowd. Thank you very much. Thank
you. Pete Lee, everybody, Pete Lee! Maybe it's me, Keenan, but I feel like this guy has a slight Asian energy to him. Maybe it's just me. Maybe it's me. What do you think of him?
Well, I thought Pete was a little too cute. Now, well, I think you're beautiful too, Keenan. No.
Please clarify.
I'm married, but you're a handsome man.
No, no. I see, that's what I liked about you, is you had a very sharp wit. And you were stepping into all the right places. Mm-hmm. It's just the point of view was slightly off. So all the things you talked about were really funny premises. The idea of being a straight guy, but no one believes you, you know?
I had trouble with it. I had trouble with it.
Now I really think he's flirting with me. Listen, we have a bromance going. This is all right.
No, but like I said, all your premises were great. It just needed, you needed to show us like what you were like when you were a kid trying to hang out with the rougher guys. What you and your wife, that's hysterical. Like you trying to be, you trying to do the husband things and all what you show, this guy you show us on stage, us trying to imagine him in these more macho situations is very funny, and that is the world you need to really explore, because you're very personal on stage, you're very clever, you know how to write. It's just you're stepping over your best stuff.
Yeah. I love that advice. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you.
Roseanne, you want to go?
Yeah, I'll go. I totally agree and appreciate the way he said it. It's like we thought you were really funny. You had the jokes, you have everything that it takes to be really successful. But we wanted you to be a little bit braver, because we were like, oh, you know, this guy's going new places that we haven't heard before.
Right.
And then you kind of let yourself off the hook too easy, because we wanted you to like, wow, we wanted to see you punch. Because I mean, for a man to like take on gender stereotyping is big stuff. Mm-hmm. I liked it was original and brave, but you know, we wanted to see you tear it down.
Yes.
You know, so that's our advice. Keep going, sharpen it up, toughen it up, and you know, you're really good. I enjoyed
thank
it.
You. Thank you. Thank you.
Russell, too cute? You agree with Keenan? Cute?
No, I didn't say cute. I wouldn't say cute, but I thought actually.
You wouldn't say cute, or is he not cute? Say cute.
I'm sure he's a cute guy. You know.
I'm asking you, cute there, or not cute?
There was a cuteness to Pete.
A cute, perfect. Okay, keep going.
I would almost disagree with Rosanna in that I thought that he was very brave to tackle the subjects of not being macho and embracing it the way he does.
Yes, but that's what we were saying. He had all the right subjects.
Yeah, no, I agree.
He
again,
just didn't explore them in as much depth as he could have. There's too many jokes about the cat. And it was like, forget the cat.
I mean, you could have lost the cat at some point.
Oh, but that cat is a huge part of my life.
it's at least 23 pounds of your life. I liked from the get-go when you said that the one line that really got me was, I'm married to my wife. She was at the wedding. I like that line a lot. I thought that was actually a very hysterical line because, you know, right away when you started talking, I was like, wait a minute. I don't know which way he's going. Oh, he's straight. You know, and I was like, wow, didn't see that coming either, you know. So
neither do any of my new friends.
Yeah, well, you know. So, I mean, you know, you're going down the right path.
Yeah.
And if you take their notes, you will be stepping right on the beats you need to be stepping on.
Well, you guys are the best, and I will listen to you all the way. Thank
you're
you.
Well, thank
sweet.
You.
Yeah. Pete Lee, everybody!